can you do this? How can you optimize your content? How can you, you know, drive these kinds of results? There's really no way around it. You have to do the work of creating rich, highly engaging content, not just status updates, not just link shares. Video and photos are a good place to start. Being responsive online, listening and engaging with your fans, all of the things that you've heard, but being able to measure the impact of those things against some of these factors of edge rank. Everybody, you know, all the kung fu masters of the internet, Google, Facebook, these guys are the keepers of the user experience online, are saying loud and clear with changes like edge rank and changes like what we've seen from Google, you must produce fresh, relevant, high-quality content if you want any online tactic to be successful, not just on Facebook, but anywhere. And there are no real shortcuts to this. You've got to make the content, and you've got to keep the audience engaged. And EdgeRank will reward you for that in the same way that Google rewards you for that. So some tactics to consider that might help with this. Exclusive content is a big one. You know, if there's something special that you can offer your fans, keep that on Facebook and share it there and get people to that content from your other channels. Exclusive deals on Facebook have been huge for us. A well-developed, interesting brand persona can be, by itself, a big driver. So if you're speaking brand language and just talking about products and not really doing it in an interesting way without any humor, not really talking like a real person, you're probably not going to see as good a result as you might if it felt like you were talking to a really interesting person online. Or a really funny person. Contesting consistently has driven results for us with EdgeRank. The framework plus campaigns, what that really means is we've seen a lot of companies take kind of just a campaign-specific approach where they say, we've got this thing and we're going to extend this campaign on Facebook for 90 days, and then Facebook kind of sits there for a while, and then they have another campaign later. What it really takes is a framework that you can execute against every minute of every hour of every day. A game plan for that campaigns can kind of sit on top of is how we've approached things, and we've had a lot of success with that. The big one is testing and optimization. Test, 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 optimize, test, 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 optimize, and so on and so forth. Things that you could test could be, you know, what time of day you're getting the best engagement, what type of content gets the best engagement. Keeping in mind those three big factors of weight, affinity, and decay, you know, what can we test to understand what's really going to drive our specific audience? Asking the user to take an action is now a much bigger deal, I think, than it's ever been before because it's an indicator of engagement, which drives affinity. So asking the user to take some action is huge. That action is going to have an EdgeRank score that Facebook will take into account the next time it's deciding whether or not to show content to that user's friends, and that user's friends' friends. And then focusing on engagement as a percentage of total audience is also another thing that we look at. So if you've got, again, a huge, huge audience, the bigger percentage of those people that you can have taking some action or showing some signs of engagement, the more affinity that you'll have and the better chances that you'll have of your content showing up in their feeds. One of the ways that we help all of our content producers with this is with this kind of like content relevancy triangle we've got over here. When we're creating content, there are three key factors that we take into account from a relevancy perspective, which is really the first step in getting content in front of people. We want to create content that's relevant to the audience and relevant to the brand, but also that's relevant to what's happening in the world. So A, audience, B, brand, W, world. It's not just about something that might be relevant to the audience and the brand at the same time. It really has to have some level of time relevance as well. So, you know, for instance, the State of the Union address was last night. How can we find some content that might be relevant to the audience and relevant to the brand at the same time, but also relevant to that particular world event that we can be talking about?